We'll continue on. I just forgot to show you on the kitchen. Have a pull out. Keeps all the you can put all your little small electrical appliances in, kind of keep the clutter up off of the countertops. Puts everything nice away. It pushes into the bunk bed bedroom, which will all be closed up. Have a nice little pantry that has all your small items in it. Also keeps your clutter out, which is all right along beside the breaker panel. Refrigerator is about where it's going to go. There'll be a wall there separate the bathroom. There'll be also another refrigerator on the side up in that little cubby hole. You can't see it here because there's a door on the other side that's open to be painted, and that'll have a separate refrigerator in there also. The Sternwheeler has a heating and air conditioning system. It's a 2.5 ton heat pump, and then we have a gas backup for the real cold days. This is the bunk bedroom, just more for storage right now. Got a lot of items. That's going to be the top floor. It runs through the whole boat. It's only got it down in the bunk bedroom right now. Haven't got the door up or anything yet. Intake system for the heat pumps all down below. Have a washing machine and dryer go in this room. Right now it's just a tool room. Keep all the tools in. There's another bedroom that's below the main bedroom. It's a sunken bedroom is what I call it. A lot of the houseboats have that. You come down below, and there'll be a queen size bed down below. Right now it's still all open. Makes it a lot easier for storage. Central air conditioning unit. Don't know how good you can see it. It's pretty much covered up in all the duct work. Water filters, water and sewer tanks. That's about what it looks like up underneath the hull. The side of the hull down there where we got some of the fuel lines, electrical lines and all running. So pretty much that way the walls are all made out of aluminum. Just took 90,000 aluminum, bent it in a Z bend. Some of them's been in a U shape and a channel. Everything's screwed and glued to the aluminum studs. There's insulation, 1/4 inch hard insulation on the outside. Then it's covered by the vinyl siding. Down here in the sunken bedroom, we insulated all the walls in it, insulated the top, because that is right underneath the bed that's in the main. Coming back into the main bedroom, we have storage for clothes. Cabinet doors will go on that one day. Got a closet. I'm gonna build a set of steps to get up to the bed. Bed is elevated. It's a little bit higher than most of the houseboats and stuff, but the point is I wanted to make it where you could walk up underneath it and still have at least 6 foot of headroom. Plasma TV, nice little fan. Also in the main bedroom, you got your sink, commode, shower. Through the main bedroom, then we'll come into the engine room. Just got the engine started yesterday. Come out of a running school bus, come out of an 86 Ford B700 school bus. Buy them for about $1,500 a piece. It's about everything you need. Just remove the body off of it, use the chassis. Everything stays consistent. Everything's factory. Got the transmission. Got a separate set of gauge panels. Keep up with what's going on with the engine. Using the same Allison transmission, we'll use the rear end differential out of the bus. Hook a sprocket to the end of it. Do a 3.5 to 1 gear reduction on the sprocket from the differential to the wheel. Gonna spin the wheel somewhere about 38 RPMs. at wide open throttle at 3,000 RPMs on the engine. Still got a lot to do with the electrical on the engine. Got idiot lights for everything. Same idiot lights that are up in the pilot house. There's an idiot light above and below each gauge. Let you know, warning, if any temperatures get above or below what it should be. Relays for starting, stopping, all that did work. A few notes of what's going on. Finished the ceiling on part of the engine room. Thought we were going to run the exhaust up and out, but now we're going to have to run the exhaust down and out the back. That little room right there, that's where the outdoor part of the air conditioning heat pump is. Makes it clean up from the back so you don't have a unit sitting on the backside. Same closed cell insulation in the, come throughout the engine room. Try to quieten it up a little bit. We'll have to do a little bit with some vents. Storage, tool storage. It's nice to have two French doors in here so we can open them up in the summertime. Don't have to worry about the heat. Same thing with the windows. Generator will be mounted back here somewhere along the wall, probably exhaust out to the outside for the radiator, so that'll help pull some more air through. School bus had an 8.2 Detroit in it. Had the air compressor and all, so I don't have to worry about an extra electrical air compressor when the engine's running. It's generating this air for the air horns. Just an 8.2 Allison AT 545 transmission. Relocated several of the filters, get them outside the chassis, make it a little bit easier for service. Water filter, fuel filter. There's access down below the engine, about right here. Engine will probably be slid over to the right about another foot. Got access down, which would be the very rear of the boat. I have access down below. That's pretty much the way the hull come to me, just the very bottom. We'll put a floor in there. Be able to store some items in there. Walking back up towards the bow of the boat. Got another floor access. This panel here, you raise it up. It's got your plumbing. I can fill each individual tank. There's four water tanks, two sewer tanks. Water tanks can be filled individually. For correcting ballast, we can remove water out of one tank and add it to another tank. Water pump, water filters. 600 gallons of water should be enough to be able to go out a couple weeks on. You conserve your water somewhat. Gonna carry 300 gallons of sewer. Has several access points. This is one that's in the middle of the kitchen. Be able to get down below. Have another one underneath this cart, right up underneath the French doors. Same thing on the other side of the boat. There's one underneath that cart. Makes it real nice to be able to get in, do service work. Another view of that front. That's about all I got for today.